Now let us discuss various practical problems in the queuing theory. Now as this is the first question, very simple question in which it has been given that the customers are arriving at a booking office which is manned by a single individual at the rate of 25. It means like 25 is the arrival rate, 25 per hour, and time required to serve the customer has exponential distribution with the mean of 30 per hour. So it is the service time. So we have to discuss various characteristics of queuing system, assuming that there is single server. So when there is one server, we know which formulas to apply. Now we will apply those formulas one by one. So here we can say lambda is 25 and mu is 30. And therefore, from the question we have seen that lambda is 25 customers per hour. And we have seen mu was 30 customers per hour. So when lambda and mu has been identified, now we can apply all the formulas. When it has been written that you have to discuss various characteristics of queuing, it means you have to find out everything. Like we have done the formulas, so one by one. So first we will find out the utilization rate, which is known as small p, that is lambda upon mu. It is 25 by 30, so it will come out to be 5 upon 6 per hour. So this is the utilization rate. We can convert it into percentage also by multiplying it with 100. Second is we can find out the idle rate. Idle rate stands for p0, which is 1 minus p, so 1 minus 5 by 6. So it comes out to be 1 upon 6 per hour. Now one by one, all the formulas we will apply. Now let's first find out number of customers in the system. We can say expected number of customers in the system. And we have seen in the formula that its short form is EN. And the formula for calculating EN is lambda divided by mu minus lambda. So our lambda is 25 divided by 30 minus 25. So here our answer will be 25 upon 5, that is 5 customers. As it is number of customers, so in the last we will be writing customers. Coming to the fourth formula, we can find out the number of customers in the queue. So expected number of customers in the queue number of customers in the queue is also known as queue length, and the short form for that is EL, and the formula is lambda square divided by mu minus lambda. So lambda in the question we have seen it was 25, so it will be 25 square divided by 30 minus 25. So the answer will be 25 by 6 customers. So we can keep it in the fractions or we can convert it into points as well. Then the fifth was expected time spent by the customer in the system and in the queue. So expected time spent by customer in the system we can calculate first. So the short form was ET and formula is 1 upon mu minus lambda. So 1 upon 30 minus 25, that is 1 upon 5 hours. As it is the time spent, so we will keep it to hours. The last formula was expected time spent by the customer in the queue, or waiting time of the customer in the queue, which is known as EW. Formula is lambda divided by mu minus lambda. So lambda is 25 divided by 30 minus 25. So its answer comes out to be 1 upon 6 hours. So it is also the time spent, so it is 1 upon 6 hours. So this is how the simple question in the queuing theory is solved. So let's see some other questions also. Now you can see in question number 2, customers arrive at a sale counter manned by a single person according to Poisson distribution
with mean rate of 20 per hour. It means customers are arriving at the mean rate of 20. This is lambda. Time required to serve the customer has exponential distribution with a mean of 100 seconds. So servicing time is 100 seconds. So we have to find out average waiting times.
So you have seen from the question that it was written that customers are arriving at the rate of 20 customers per hour. So it is what the lambda has directly been given in the question. Then it was given that time required to serve a customer. It means mu was given with a mean of 100 seconds. It means for one customer, the company has to invest 100 seconds. So we have to find out how many customers are coming out in 1 hour. So accordingly, we will change these seconds into hours. So if one customer is taking 100 seconds, so total we have 3600 seconds, 60 into 60 by 100. So it means 36 customers will be taking the service and they will be coming out from the service center. So you can show it like that. So it was given 20 customers per hour, very direct, but here it was given every customer is given 100 second service. So we have to find out in 1 hour how many customers will be served by the company. So we have taken the total seconds in 1 hour, 3600 by 100. So 36 customers were getting the service in 1 hour. Now we have lambda and mu, and in the question it was written that you have to calculate the time spent by the customer in the system and time spent by the customer in the queue. So first of all, let us find out the time spent by customer in the system. Time spent by customer in system. Time spent by customer in the system is known as ET, and the formula is 1 upon mu minus lambda, that is 1 upon 36 by 20. So it comes out to be 1 upon 16. So if you want to leave the question here, you can leave. So this answer is in hours. But if you want to convert the answer into seconds, you can also do that by multiplying it with 3600. So because in between somewhere seconds were also given. So in the answer, you can show it in seconds also. So it will be 125 seconds. Next will be time spent by the customer in the queue. So we know that time spent by the customer in the queue is known as EW, and the formula for EW is lambda divided by mu minus lambda. So we can fill the values over there. So lambda is 20 divided by 36 minus 20. So from here we will be getting the answer, that is 20 divided by 36 into 16. We can solve this and just put the hours at the last, or if you want to convert it into the seconds, we can also do that. So its answer will be 125 seconds. So you can show the answer in seconds, or you can show the answer in hours as well. And this is another question. You can see customers are getting the service, and for every customer, 6 minutes per customer is the time spent by the company. So we know that service time is mu. So if the 6 minute service is given to every customer, so how many customers will be taking the service in 1 hour? Of course, 10 customers. How we calculated that? 60 upon 6, that is 10 customers per hour are taking the service. I repeat again, every customer takes 6 minutes. So if 6 minutes are being given to every worker, every customer, so in 1 hour, of course, 10 customers will be coming out. So we have calculated like that. Then it is given on an average, every 12 minutes, one customer arrive. So this is arrival rate. So in every 12 minutes, one customer is arriving. So in 1 hour, how many customers will be arriving? That is 60 upon 12. So it will be 5 customers per hour will be arriving. So here in this question, it has been given first point to calculate the utilization rate. We know that utilization rate is denoted with the small p, and the formula for small p is lambda upon mu. Lambda is 5 upon mu is 10, so 0.5 5 is the utilization rate, or you can say if we multiply it with 100, it will be 50% is the utilization rate. Then in the second point, it has been asked that what is the time spent by the customer. So time spent by the customer, we know that it is known as ET in case of system. So time spent by the customer is ET, and the formula is 1 upon mu minus lambda. So it will be 1 upon 10 minus 5, or you can say 1 upon 5 hours, because we have converted the question into hours. So it will be 1 upon 5 hours. The third thing in this question was Q length was asked. We know that Q length is number of customers in the queue, that is EL, and the formula is lambda square divided by mu minus lambda. So we can fill the values. Lambda square means 5 square divided by 10 minus 5. So it comes out to be 0.5 customers. So we can show it like that. So like this, you can solve the question whatever has been asked after finding lambda and mu. Now there can be such questions as well. See, in this question it has been given that customers, when they are being served, the time is 20 minutes. So it takes 20 minutes to serve a customer. So we can find out in hours, but in after looking at the arrival rate, you can see it is written that arrival rate is 10 customers per 8 hours day. So 10 customers are coming in 8 hours day. So day is fully of the 8 hours it has been given. And then it is given that 10 customers are coming in that 8 hours day. Now in this question we can see that customer service time is 20 minutes per customer. So service time is 20 minutes per customer. So we have to find in 1 hour. So it will be 60 by 20. That is 3 customers will be getting the service per hour. Because in 20 minutes, one customer is getting the service. So of course, in 1 hour, 3 customers will be getting the service. Next comes lambda. Lambda rate is 10 customers per 8 hours. So 8 hour day. So in the organization, maybe 8 hour is the working time. And the arrival rate is 10 customer per 8 hour day. So it means in the full day, 8 hours, 10 customers are coming. So how many customers will be coming in 1 hour? That is 10 upon 8, or we can say it will be 5 upon 4 customers per hour. So now we have calculated the lambda and the mu. Now whatever will be asked, we will find out. Now in this question, the first point has been asked, you have to calculate expected idle time per day. So we will find out idle time. Now we all know what is idle time, that is P0, or we can say 1 minus P, and 1 minus P stands for lambda upon mu. So 1 minus 5 upon 4 divided by 3, or we can say is 1 upon 5 divided by 12. So taking the LCM, it will be 12 minus 5, that is 7 by 12 hours. But in the question, it has been asked to calculate expected idle time per day. So it means we will have to calculate our answer with 8, because it has been given in the question that the company works for 8 hours. So we have multiplied our answer of hours with 8, and by cancelling, it will be 14 by 3 hours per day. So this is the first answer, that idle time per day. We have done nothing, just putting the formula, and as it was asked per day, so we have multiplied it with 8 hours. Now the second thing it has been asked is how many jobs are there, because this was the question of jobs, or you can say customers. How many jobs are there ahead of average set just bought in? It means the set that has just come, or the customer that has just come, before that, ahead, how many jobs are there? Now whichever job is coming, or whatever customer is coming, he or she will have to join the queue. So we have to find how many are ahead of that customer. It means we have to find out how many are there in the queue plus how many are taking the service. So you have to find out expected number of customers in this system, That is, we will find out EN. I repeat again. Here the customer means jobs. So jobs are being coming for getting the service. So here we have been asked to find out how many jobs are ahead when the job that has just brought in. The job that has just come will be joining the queue from the last. So you have to find out the queue length plus the jobs who are already taking the service. So number of customers in the system will be find out. That is EN. And the formula for EN is lambda divided by mu minus lambda. So now filling the value into it, lambda is 5 upon 4 divided by 3 minus 5 upon 4. Now solving this, it will be 5 upon 4 divided by taking the LCM, it will be 12 minus 5 upon 4, that is 7 upon 4. So we can cancel it and answer will be 5 upon 7 jobs or customers. Therefore, this is how the simple questions related to queuing theory are solved.